Okay, so today we are going to see the command sort. So there are a lot of options with sort. Very simple is sorting line based, and then there are ways to sort based on columns and other options. So we'll see one by one. Okay. Okay, so first we'll simply do a sort. So okay, just hold on. Okay, so I had the wrong input anyways. So let's consider the input, okay, and let's sort it. So you can see that it is sorted alphabetic order. So that's a default sort. The sorting depends on various conditions. So if you go to the documentation info sort, okay, so you will see a big note. It says that, I mean, basically this depends on locale. That defines basically how sort happens. So basically what is sort? So it compares between, let's say, number sorting, okay, so it compares one number against another number. So you need to know the default ascending sort, okay. You need a way to tell, okay, this number comes first and that number comes next, correct? So similarly for so our text file can be ASCII encoded, Unicode encoded, and stuff like that, okay. So there are various ways your input file could be. So for depending on that, there are different options. So this will or if we have a local language and stuff like that, so you need to be able to tell sort that, okay, this is the way I want to sort it, okay. So for that, so these are all the settings there. In this session we'll be dealing only with simple ASCII coded input file, so I won't be going much about all this, but you need to keep it in mind, okay. So sorting needs a rule based on which it should be sorted, okay. So coming to this example, so this is a very simple example. You use the command sort and you provide one or more file inputs, okay. So you can simply see, okay, it has sorted based on alphabetic order. Let's see more examples. So assume that you have a command which extracts something and you want to sort it, okay. So sort can accept input from standard input also. So you don't necessarily need a input file. So assume that you have a lot of words like this and you want to sort it, okay. So you can see that this is one place where the default sort comes into picture. It depends on the settings. So both lowercase and uppercase are considered, I mean, by default it is irrespective of the case. So you can see all the A's are first, then B, then and so on. So this is a default alphabetic sort. So comparing one string is compared against another string, and based on the ASCII values, so these strings come before these strings, okay. So one example to show how local settings can affect it. So here we are providing an environmental variable to sort, saying that you want to sort based on C. C is basically your C language, okay. So here you can see all the capitals are first and then lower cases are next. Okay, so this is just one simple example to tell how the local settings can differ. For more information, just go through these links or as well as the info sort. For each option and particular thing, there is information how to use them. Okay. For our case, we'll simply be using the default sorting. So let's see another option. So this is by default, it is ascending order. So by using minus R, basically reverse the order. So you get descending. Okay. Any doubts so far? Okay, so let's move on to more cases. So simple sorting, I think, is clear. Yes. So let's deal with numbers. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So let's say you have a text file with numbers. Okay. The thing is, sort does not know that these are numbers or not. Okay. So sort basically sorts based on string. Okay. By default, it does a string comparison. It does not know what is a number. Okay. So let's see what happens when you don't give an option. So you can see that it does not know that 101 is greater than 20. Okay, it simply did a string comparison. Okay, there is a default way to sort, which is basically string comparison. So to tell that, okay, I want to sort based on numbers. Okay, my input is basically considered, treat them as number, not as string. So then you have to use the option minus n. Okay, so what minus n will do is it will try to get the first number in the line. Okay, and then it basically tries to convert that particular string into a number, and then it will sort it. Now you can see this is the default ascending sort. You can add reverse sort. So this is ascending and this is descending. So by using minus n option, you can tell to sort that, okay, I want to sort only based on numbers. So what defines a number? Okay, so a very simple example is what we have seen here, but you got to know what does sort consider as numbers. So so according to man page, okay, sort can understand negative numbers. Okay, negative is basically a number preceded by hyphen, and it can also understand thousand separator and decimal point. Okay, what is that separator depends on local settings. Okay, in my local settings, comma is the thousand separator and dot is the decimal separator. Okay, so this, let's see these examples quickly. So another thing to notice, by default sort will concatenate all its input and then it will sort it. Okay, you don't need to use cat. So by default sort will any number of input which is given, let's say we add another thing. Okay, so whatever is the number of inputs, all the lines are concatenated and sort will accept that. So here it's an example to tell that, to show that minus n also knows a negative number. Okay. Now, let's say we add a thousand separator. Okay, this depends on your local settings. So you can see that it understood that 7,500 is 7,500. Okay, and accordingly it has sorted. It's from decimal point. Okay, so in my local, dot is the decimal point separator. So you can see that it understands whether a number based on decimal point, it knows that okay, this is 12.43. Okay, and accordingly it places between 3 and 20. So what we have seen is minus n understands numbers. It knows negative numbers. It knows whole integers. It also knows numbers with decimal points or numbers with thousand separator. All right. Any doubt? Okay, let's move on. Assume that you have input file with numbers like this. Okay. Now, what is this? Correct? So this is basically E scientific notation. Okay. You can look into Wiki to know the details. Basically, there's a number, and then it has a symbol E, and then you have the power. So E, you can so this is equal to 3.14 into 10 to the power of 4. Okay. I have a handy command to tell that. Okay. You can also see this one. Okay. Fine. So, and one more thing is, plus 120 is basically same as 120. Okay, but your sort with a sort with minus n does not understand plus. Okay, the plus is not needed, but your minus n does not understand what is plus 120. Okay, so it simply did something else. So cases like where you have scientific notation, or you have a number with positive, I mean, plus as a prefix, we have to use another option. Okay. So that option is G. Okay. So this G basically understands all these extra formats. This one is understood by minus n also, but I just added an example. So G understands the scientific notation as well as numbers prefixed with a plus. Okay. So let's recap. So we are seeing how to sort file with numbers in it. Okay. So if you have numbers or negative numbers or numbers with decimal and thousand separator, you can simply use minus n option. Okay. If you want to do a descending order, then just add minus r. So minus r is independent of your other options. And if you have numbers with scientific notation or numbers prefixed with a plus, then use the minus g. So it is a generic sort, generic numbers. Okay. One thing to notice, this will be pretty slow. Okay. Because it has to convert a lot of stuff. So yeah, so another good example. Okay, so we have seen minus n and minus g. Okay, we have another option, minus h. Okay, this I'll just show, explain it here. I don't have a sample to show on the command line. So if you know the command du, so basically it reports file sizes or your directory sizes. Okay, when you use the h option, it will use the suffix k, m, etc. to indicate. So this is kilo, this is mega. Okay, so this is human, h stands for human readable format. Okay, human readable format. So assume that in a particular folder you have these files and one folder. Okay, and let's say their sizes are this. So this is 104k, k is 1024, okay, 1024 bytes, 746 meg, 316 kilo and 20 kilo. Okay, so you have different file sizes. Let's say you want to sort this. Okay, so then sort has a handy minus h option. You can see it knows the difference between k and m, and accordingly it has sorted. Okay, another thing to notice, it also knows the so this k and m are in the powers of 1024. Okay, du also has an option hyphen hyphen si, which uses powers of 1000. So this is 107 into 1000. This is 104 into 1024. Okay, so you use this h option or hyphen hyphen si, does not matter. Sort can handle both. Okay, whether it be small k or capital K, you can use the sort minus h option. So we'll see the last option regarding numbers. Okay, we are still seeing examples for sorting with numbers. So one is just normal numbers, next is numbers like scientific notation. Then we saw human readable formats, which is mainly dealing with file sizes. Okay, next comes version. Okay, you know, like Git version or any product versions. Okay, so let's say you have so basic difference between version and decimal point is you have a lot of decimal points. Okay, you have more than one, correct? And more often than not, you will have text also combined with it. So sort, so before going to this, let me show something with ls also. Okay, so for example, let's say you have files like this. Okay, and you want to display. Now if you want to display this based on numbers also, sorted by numbers, there's an option minus v. okay, so this minus v stands for version short. So it knows like, first of all, it will sort based on the normal string. Then if there are numbers, this minus 3 will handle that. Okay, it knows that 0 comes before 2 and 2 comes before 10, but normally it will simply sort based on string. Okay, it does not know the numbers embedded in that string. So what we are going to see with sort minus 3 is same. So if you use sort minus v, it is similar to this ls minus v option. So first of all, it sort based on string. Okay, bar comes before foo, so this is your normal default sort. Afterwards, So this is based on version. So 1.2 is before 1.2.1, and that is before 1.3, and so on. Okay. So this is the last number based sort, which is version sort. So shall we move on to the next topic? Okay. So just before that, let me also give another example. Okay. Just to drive home the point. So I hope you know the time command. Okay. So let's say, okay. So time command, it reports in this format. Okay. It is minute and seconds. So let's say you collected this thing in from different sources. So this is the let's say you have a file, and for some reason all the files are already sorted. Okay. So let's say you have the time information for from different things. Okay. So here also, if you do minus V, you can see that 3 minute is before 4 minute, and 4 minute 5 is before 4 minute 33. Okay. So it knows 5 is less than 33. Okay. So minus V not only does version shorten, it also understands that. It also handles text in between that. Okay. Obviously, this is, you need a consistent format here, both minute and second. If you have hour here, then it will not know the difference between M and H. Okay. It is not that powerful also, but it helps in various cases like this. Either you have Git versions or you have time, you can use version short. Okay, random sort. So you have an option minus capital R. Okay. So instead of sorting in ascending or descending order, this will sort in a random order. Okay. One thing to notice, if you have a duplicate line, okay, it will always be together. You can see between different runs, it will sort differently, but the duplicate lines are always together. Okay. So that is because how it is implemented, it is randomly pasting the hash keys. Okay. All the detail is there in the manual page. But what you need to know is duplicate lines are always together. So if you don't want that, you should use the suf command. Okay, there is a separate command. Okay, yeah. So if usually you'll have another command just for random things. Okay, so this suf command does not know what is a duplicate line. It simply randomizes all the lines. Okay, so you can see here 10 and 10 are separated. They can be together also. So just keep that in mind. So you have sort random. Okay, if there are duplicate lines, they are always together, but otherwise you will get a random order. Okay. So let's say you want to sort this file, and as well as modify the same file. So what you can do is, you can use the minus O option to specify an output file. Okay. So by using this option, if you want, you can modify the same file. Okay. It will not override it. So sort knows that this is the input file, and after it has got the output, it will write to this file. Okay. So sort will handle all that creating temporary file and stuff like that. So if you want a in place editing, use the minus O option. If you have multiple files, then you will have to use a for loop. So basically, let's say you have a lot of files to sort in place. Okay. So what you can do is use a for loop, then do a sort. This is whatever option, minus N, minus R, minus capital R, etc. Okay. This is your file name, and minus O, and as well as the file given to minus O should be the same. So you can always give a different one. You can say dollar F, okay, dot sorted or something like that. Okay, you can always give a different name also. If you want in place, then you can use a for loop. Okay. Okay, so shall we move to next topic? Okay, so next is unique sort. So basically, so when you say sort, if there are duplicate lines, they will always be next to each other. Okay. Now if you want only one copy of that, okay, so you can use minus U to tell, okay, I want only the unique thing. Let me give another example. Okay, so let's say you have a lot of words. Okay, if you see these words are repeated. Okay, so some words are repeated more than once. So you can use minus U option to get only once. So let me just give another example. So when you use the option minus N, okay, so it will try to get whatever is the first number, okay, and based on that it will sort. Okay, the rest of the string does not matter to it. So for food, basically you can consider it as zero or something like that. Okay. And then other numbers are there. So when you use minus U option on this, okay, so foo and foo, obviously they are same, so you get one unique line. Okay, five guavas, again one line. Okay, now see what has happened. It retain only apples and not carrots. Okay, because when you are using minus N option, so for this line, basically 12 is a number. Okay, rest of the line does not matter to it. So this and this are considered duplicate lines when you use minus N option. Okay, so if if that is not desirable, so what you can do is instead of that you can use the unique command. So that we'll see in a later session. So there is a command unique that will work line based. Okay, it will be line based. Here, when you are using sort, you should be careful when you are using numbers and unique. Okay, the unique number is based on only the number which is found, not the entire line. Okay, another example for unique. Okay, consider this example. There are different words here. So here R and R are repeated, so only one time it came, and then this and this are considered different. Okay, and car and car are again considered different, and foot is different. So basically this is case sensitive. By default, here this is case sensitive. If you want a case insensitive, then use the option minus F. Okay, basically it is fold case. Minus F is basically fold case. So in effect you will get case insensitive unique option. Now why this word or this word is chosen depends on order. Okay, so whichever comes first. So in the input file, capital A and small re is first before this. Okay, so this will be chosen in the output. Here car again is before CAR, so the first occurrence will be chosen as your unique line. Okay, so if you go back to this example, so duplicates here, 12 apples comes before 12 carrots. Okay, so when you use minus and U, this apple line is chosen as the unique line, and whatever line comes after that is the duplicate. So here this is the unique line and these are duplicates. This is unique and this is duplicate. So first match is retained in the output, so that you should know. Clear? Let's move on. Okay, next we'll see column based sorting. Okay, so this is a big topic. There are lot of options and tricks and tips in this. Okay, so whatever examples we have seen before, it is all line based sorting. Okay, so entire line is considered to sort it, but often you will have like multiple columns. Okay, so we'll see how to sort based on column. Okay, so let's say you have two columns here. Okay, and in between that you have space, so we call that as blank. Okay, blank is basically space or tab. Okay, blank characters. So this thing, right? So it could be space or tab. So this is considered as blank characters, and that is how the default column separation is blank characters. Okay, so let's say you want to sort by second column. So what we do is we use the option K. Okay, and then K takes lot of options, we'll see one by one. So you have to first specify which column you want to sort. Okay, 2, then use a comma, and then you have to tell this is the starting column number, then you have to specify a ending column number. Okay, so in this case my starting and ending is both second column, so I can say 2, 2. So this is start and this is end. Okay, we'll see more examples to know that better. And then you give the file name. Okay, so here basically it sorted, it does not know the numbers, right? So you use the option n. So just remember, when you want to sort based on numbers, use the appropriate -n or -v or -g or -h accordingly. Okay, so here we are sorting based on numbers. So this is the column to sort, and you, after that you can give any option. You can also give a reverse order. Okay, so this is sorting based on the second column, and first column is like accordingly it will choose. So it chooses 90, and whatever is the remaining line, it will automatically be placed there. So this syntax, this is the minus k is to tell that you want to, it stands for key. So this is the starting column and this is the ending column. All right. So in this particular case, we can also say like this. Okay, when you omit a comma and the ending column, what it means is from that column till end of the line. Okay, so in this case, just minus k2 is enough. But this is the most preferred format, which will become clear later. Okay, let's move on to more examples. Okay, for some reason all the files are sorted. Fine. So let's consider a file called pets.txt. Okay, so this is the name, this is the pet, and this is the number of pets. Okay, so if you want to sort based on first column, right, you don't need to specify, that is the default. Okay, so here like even without specifying minus k1, in effect you will get sorting based on first column. Okay, because it does not know what is column and all stuff like that. But now let's say you want to sort based on second column or a third column. Okay, the thing to note is by default the column separator is a blank. Now if you want to specify another character as the separation, then you have to use option T. Okay, so T is used to specify what is the input delimiter. Now the second column is basically alphabets, right? So you just use 2, 2 and then pets. So you can see that the only the second column, I mean the sorting is based on second column. So cat and then dog and then fox, then parrot and squirrel. So this way we can specify what is the field separator or a column separator. Okay, and then this is the key. So you are telling you want to sort second, from second to second. Start and end is the same. So this is single column. Now see the difference between 2, 2 and 2. So when you say 2, 2, you are sorting only based on second column. Okay. Now there are multiple entries, right? So how does sort take care of that? What it will do is, it will use the remaining line as the tiebreaker. Okay. So once you get multiple entries, you can see that the remaining line becomes the tiebreaker. So here you can see that these are in alphabetic order. This is alphabetic order, correct? So if there are multiple entries, when you specify only single column, the remaining becomes the tiebreaker, and you can see here that this is alphabetic order. Now what I have done here, I am saying just 2. So when you don't specify the ending, then from second column till end becomes the sorting order. Okay. So what has happened here is, so cat colon 1 comes before cat colon 3. Okay. Dog colon 1 comes before dog colon 10, which comes before dog colon 2. Because you are not specifying number, okay, it does not know 10 is greater than 2. All right. So when we say K2, it means from second column till end of the line. So this entire string is considered as the key. Okay. In this case, we specify 2, 2, which means only the second column alone is the key. After that, the remaining line is used. So here, cat and cat, the first column is in alphabetic order. Okay. Here K2 means this from second column till end of the line is considered. So cat colon 1 comes before cat colon 3. Dog colon 1 comes before dog colon 10. Now if you have 2 entries with cat colon 1 and cat colon 1, in that case, then the remaining line also will be considered. Okay. Finally, by default, sort will consider remaining portion of the line to deal with tie. Okay. But this example I am telling you more to show the difference between specifying single column versus multiple columns. Okay. Now just to complete this example, use a number. Okay, this will not work. So let me, yeah, so this is a good example for specifying multiple keys. All right. Okay. So this is defining our own deal breakers. Sorry, our own tie breakers. So what this means is, first sort based on second column. Okay. And then sort based on numbers for the third column. So if you have multiple entries, use this as the tie breaker. So cat and cat is there. Which should come first is determined by the third column. So third column, I'm using the number sort. So 1 comes before 3. You can see there are 3 dog entries. 1 comes before 2 and 2 comes before 10. You can do a reverse. So what you have to remember is, all this option applies only to that particular column, not the rest of the line. So here 3 comes before 1 because this is descending order, 10, 2, 1. Okay. So before moving on, so if you have doubt, let me know. What we are seeing is, we are seeing key based sorting. Minus T is used to specify a delimiter. By default, it is a blank. Then you can specify multiple keys And when you specify a key, you have to tell what is the starting and the ending column. Okay. And each key can have its own different options. Okay. So here, if you see another example, if you specify an R here, you can see squirrel comes before parrot. Okay. So each key can have its own options, and the order matters. So if you specify this, then this becomes the first key, and this will come into picture only if there are ties. Okay. So before moving on, if you have doubts, you can ask now. Okay, so let's move on. Yeah, so a lot of practice is definitely needed. So hopefully just go through this examples, copy these files, okay, and try to change it. Okay, just try to give a different option here or different numbers here. Okay, definitely a lot of practice is required. So all this, I mean, these examples we have seen. Okay, so, but let me quickly show this again. So here, second column is the first key and third column is the tiebreaker. If you reverse it, so when you reverse this, you can see that the third column numbers is the order. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. Okay. So the third column is the first key. If there are ties, if there are multiple third column with the same value, then you can specify another thing. So here, if you specify second column, so this is the alphabetic order, cat, dog, fox. Okay. If you don't specify that, then the remaining entire line is considered as tiebreaker. So you can see the first column comes into picture. Okay. So as you said, yeah, you need to practice, but one simple thing you know need to know is the left to right order matters. You can specify what to sort first and then what to use when there are multiple entries. Okay, so here second column, cat, dog, fox, etc. Here numbers 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay, so now comes an option minus yes. Let me show the input file also. So here a simple sort, I am sorting based on third column number. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. And what happens is, if there are multiple entries, the remaining line is used to sort. Okay, so bar, Joe, and XYZ. So alphabetic order. If you see the input file, so bar is first, which is same here, XYZ, and then Joe. Okay, so you can see the order has changed. If you don't want that order to change, okay, let me show the input again. So if you want, so there are three ones, okay, bar, XYZ, and Joe. If you want the same order in the output, then use the option minus s. Okay, so what minus s will do is it will use whatever key you are giving, okay, and then it will not use the remaining line. So whatever is the input order, that will be retained. Okay, so this is helpful for certain cases. Let's say you have multiple sorting, okay, based on multiple criteria. So you don't want to change what is already sorted. Okay, so for some reason, let's say in the input, this line comes before this line and which comes before this line. Okay, so let's say this is based on some particular order. So you don't want to disturb that order, then you can use the minus s. Okay, so when you use minus u, minus s is by default implied. Okay, whatever is the first line is matched, that only will be the output. So when you use unique, okay, you can see that unique, I am specifying based on a column. So only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Even though there are three ones, only one of them is in the output. Okay, because you are telling unique based on column 3. And you can see only the first line which has the number 1 is retained in the output. The remaining are duplicates. So when you use minus u, minus s is implied. Okay. So one final topic. Okay. So this is just one final topic remaining. Okay. So far what we have seen is so far we have seen line based sorting and column based sorting, correct? So there is one more in column based sorting, you can also specify the characters. Okay, so consider this example. So comma is my field separator. Okay, here what I'm telling is I want to sort based on second column, correct? So k2 comma 2 is sort based on second column. Even if you say so my second column is a kind of special format. Okay, so let's say the first three characters are some letters. Okay, and you don't care about that, you want only these numbers. Okay, you want to sort only these numbers. So now if you use 2,2n, you get some random thing. Okay, let me not get into detail how this comes into picture. So this is my problem statement. I have a file with three columns separated by comma. Okay, my second column has a particular format. So there are some characters up front and then you have a number. Okay, so if you want to skip this, okay, what you can do is, so you can specify which character to start with. Okay, so 2.4 means I want to skip these characters. In short, 2.4 means it will take all the characters from fourth. Okay, so if you want, so you can see here 4, 5, 12, 48, 93 and 342. What I have done is I have skipped these three characters when I am sorting the second column. Okay, so this is basically telling that 2.4 is my starting column to sort. Okay, 2 is second column and 4 is the starting character. I have not specified the ending character, so that becomes by default up to the end. Okay, if you want, you can use, just for example sake. Okay, so if you say 2.4 to 2.5, which means fourth and fifth character. Okay, so this is 5, 12, 34, 48 and 93. Even though this is 342, only the characters 4 and 5 are considered. So 5, 12, 34, 48 and 93. So like specifying column K2, 4 is second, third and fourth column. Similarly, you can use the dot version to specify which character you want. Okay, so this depends on your column input. If you know that, okay, these characters can be skipped, or you want only particular characters from a column, so you can use this. So that wraps it around. Okay, like you said, there are, you need to practice a lot. So there are further links for like specific topics or some tutorials. Okay, and when you have doubt, you can always use manual page or the info page. Okay, and these examples are there. Practice, and if any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, so right now, shall we finish the session? All right. Cool. Good night.